Hello beautiful people, welcome back to Jikoni Yangu. For those who are new here, my name is Sebi and in today's video I'm going to teach you guys on how to make your homemade burgers. I'm going to teach you on how to make the sauce to your burger in a delicious manner. So stay tuned to the video till the end. So what we have our bacons for our toppings and then we have our beef burgers that I bought in the supermarket. Yeah. And then I have my ingredients. I have my onions, capsicum, and then I have my blended tomatoes. I blended 1.5 tomatoes. And we have our garlic, beef cube, and our tomato paste. First and foremost, we are going to begin by making the toppings first. So we are going to add oil into our pan and add in our bacons and ensure that they cook. I don't like my bacons too crunchy. For this recipe, I prefer my bacon medium crunchy, if you get what I mean. So this is what we have right now, and as you can see our bacons are here, and this is just what I like, just cooked very well, not overcooked. And we're going to set that aside in a plate, and then the next thing we're going to do, we are going to break our garlic into two and then place them in the oil and add in our burgers. We want the fragrance to come inside the burgers, and also we want that amazing flavor inside our burgers. So that is what we are doing next. We're going to cook our burgers until they are nicely browned. You make sure you cook your burgers on medium heat so that they're able to cook on the inside as well. So as you can see, I'm turning them on each side. Let it cook first of all and brown on one side so that you can be able to turn it on the other side to also prevent breakage during cooking. So this is what we have, and you can really tell now that our burgers are cooked. Remember to cook them on medium heat so that they can cook on the inside. So at this point, I have removed my garlic so that we cannot get the burning effect inside our oil, the burning taste. And then now we're going to set aside our burgers in a plate. And the next thing, guys, we are going to now create the sauce. This is where everything is at. Yeah, creating the sauce. So on the same sufuria, guys, we're going to add in our capsicum all together with our onions, and we're going to saute it for 2 to 3 minutes. We want our onions to be translucent, we don't want them to turn brown. So that is what we are doing here, because we need all the onions inside our burgers. I love myself some onions, do you? So far, if you've reached up to this point, please give this video a thumbs up. It really supports this channel. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet and comment down below. Yeah. So let's continue to saute. And this is what we have at the moment. And this is what we need for our burgers. So we are going to go in with our blended tomato or tomato puree inside our mixture, and then we are at this point cooking them on medium heat. We are going to add in our beef cube, our 1 teaspoon of tomato paste, and then we are going to mix that all together. And remember, guys, you're going to test your salt inside your sauce. So if there's no enough salt, remember the beef cube has salt, so be careful when you're adding in your salt into your stew so that you don't put in excess salt. So we are going to saute that for some time and let it cook on medium heat. And we want a thick stew because we are creating the sauce for the burger. So this is it. At this point is where I've added in my salt because I felt like there was no enough salt inside my sauce. We're going to mix that a little bit. As you can see at this point, I really love the aroma that is coming from this pan. And I also love the color. My God, so this is what we have. And yeah, you're going to just cook your tomato puree all together with the tomato paste until it goes down like this. So it dries up. That's the right word to use. So add in your burgers inside the sauce because we want all the goodness, guys, and this is what we have. So you're going to take your buns and you're going to add in your burgers and your toppings, and this is what we have. This burger was really delicious, guys. I kid you not, try out this recipe. I really love the outcome, and this is how I normally make my burgers at home. This is how I create my sauce, my self-taught sauce at home.
And this is what we have. Try out this recipe. Let me know how it goes. It was really delicious. And bye till my next video.